Well, as we reach the top of the hour, what a better time to bring in Sean Farnham to help us have some perspective on what these Peacocks of St. Peter's are doing. And, Sean, I mentioned earlier they've won 10 straight games. Okay, that's great. Three in a row, obviously, in the tournament to get to this point. But the caliber of teams they've beaten these last three, not just Kentucky and Purdue, but even Murray State was an OVC champion, and they had won a lot of games in a row. How are these Peacocks doing it, though?
I think it's mainly a reflection of their leadership from their coach, and I think it's from the mental approach in which they're playing with. Look, we could talk about their guards, and their guards are disruptive at the defensive end of the floor, and as you guys were talking about, so elite at the free throw line. They extend out their pressure. They were disruptive. All those things are fine, but I think so much of what we see in March comes down to your ability to compartmentalize and look at this as really one game at a time. And Shaheen Holloway has done a tremendous job, because it's one thing to knock off Kentucky and then Murray State, but then you got to go home before you come back and get to the Sweet 16. And everybody on your campus is telling you how amazing this is and what a great Cinderella run it is. And you start to feel it a little bit. This team didn't feel it. This team is laser focused, and they have bought into the messaging from their head coach. And the poise and the maturity and the leadership we've seen from their coach has permeated throughout his entire roster. They have not been the one that has found the slipper and continued to dance. They have been the one that's been leading the dance in all three of the games in which they've played. They have not acted the part of a Cinderella, although they labeled the part of a Cinderella. They have won these games, and they have out-executed their opponent every single contest.
There's no bigger college basketball fan than Dick Vitale, and he was on Twitter earlier, trademark style for Dickie V, to send out this tweet. I can't believe a 15 seed could beat Kentucky, Murray State, Purdue. And the Peacocks did it on National Peacock Day. Tip of the hat to the calm, cool coach, Shaheen Holloway. Shaheen, the dream. Hope those Jersey corporate giants get some NIL deals for those players. Yes, never believe in can't. I show you that, though, to set up this question. As St. Peter's continues to win, what's more likely here? They gain greater confidence, or their next opponent feels greater pressure?
I think that they're going to gain more confidence, Michael. I think you saw it in the press conference after the game tonight. They realize that, you know, Tom Brady at the end of the season said he was satisfied, which was an indication that he was going to retire, and then he unretired, right? These guys, they're not satisfied. They're enjoying this journey. They're celebrating the moments that they're sharing with one another right now, and they're looking at each other, and they're going to let this one sink in, but they're 40 minutes away from the Final Four. They're 40 minutes away from the four. And when I played at UCLA, after every game, we talked about how many games or how many minutes we were away from that magical moment. Only once in my career at UCLA did I get as close right now as what St. Peter's has been able to accomplish. And these guys are going to love it. And they've got another opponent standing right in front of them that they're going to line up against. And their guards are going to try to be disruptive once again and give themselves an opportunity to get to New Orleans and see if this magic can continue. Because they're playing as well and as confident as any team left in the field.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.